Hello everyone, this is our new tracker design. It's called the VALTRACK-V4-VTS-ESP32-C3 because it is using the ESP32-C3 MC on it instead of the STM32 which was used in the earlier design. So here is the ESP32-C3 MC, and it will be having support for a Bluetooth plus Wi-Fi chip antenna here. This is a 2.4 GHz chip antenna, and ESP32-C3 uses a 40 MHz crystal here. And we are powering the ESP32-C3 using the RT9080 LDO regulator, which can supply enough current for the ESP32 transmissions and everything. This is the LS3D accelerometer for motion detection purposes, and there is a micro USB connector provided here for programming the ESP32 and seeing the logs which are coming from the firmware. And there are two buttons which are very common in all the ESP32 designs. One is for the reset and another is for GPIO 9 here. And this is the level transmitter for the cellular module, which is AA7672S, which is there on this other side. So all the features of the VALTRACK-V4-VTS design remain the same. There is the same TPS54240 switching regulator, which will provide the necessary 4 volts for operation of the whole circuit, including the cellular module, the accelerometer, and the ESP32. So here TPS54240 is taking in a voltage of up to 12 volts from the vehicle battery. It can support up to 42 volts also, because it's rated at that voltage. And the 12 volt input coming in from these two wires is actually having some protection here on the reverse polarity protection using this diode. There is a fuse for overcurrent protection, and then it reaches the TPS54240, which will convert it to actually 5 volts. It will give 5 volts here to the MP2617 battery charger chip, which will again take care of reducing it to 4 volts. And it also has this battery input, which will actually take the battery input also as a emergency power source when the main battery is disconnected. Whenever the 12 volt source is disconnected, the MP2617 takes care of switching to the internal battery which is connected to this. You can use a small LiPo battery, maybe a 400 mAh. This is quite a little bit bigger because it doesn't fit in the enclosure. You can actually use a smaller one. And here this is the main MOSFET, power MOSFET, which is used for powering and disconnecting power for the cellular module. So when we are having no motion, when there is no motion detected, the power to A7672S is cut off. There will be different variants of this tracker, wherein we can use A7672S for the Indian subcontinent, which work in neighboring regions of India. And there is another variant called A7672E, which will work for the European continent. And there is A7672SA, which will be supporting South American bands. And the SA also supports North American band also, but there are some exceptions wherein couple of bands are not supported using A7672SA. So there is full support for Europe using A7672E. This is the cellular antenna. This is used in most of our designs. There is a newer 4G LTE antenna which will be using instead of this, but for now we are using this one. And then there are two mounting holes provided, so instead of 4, because there was no space on the PCB, so we are managing with 2 mounting holes here, as you can see in this design. As you can see here, we are using only 2 mounting holes instead of 4, when the patch antenna and SIM card are optimally placed in that screw hole areas. Coming to the other side of the PCB, as you can see, there is a major change. We are using a pulse 3225 patch antenna here. We are using the A7672S internal GNSS instead of the Telic module which we are using earlier. So this is all done to keep the costs low, and we will be running the A7672S GNSS in passive antenna mode. So this is connected as a passive antenna to the A7672S module. And ESP32-C3 is connected to via UART to the cellular module, and it is connected by I2C to the LS3DH accelerometer. And the one more important peripheral we need to talk about is the 3 LEDs here. these three LEDs U50 and 50 to 53, this one is for indicating power power status, and this is for network, and this is for the location information. So these three are all not normal LEDs. They are all WS2812 series LEDs, which are connected in cascade, wherein we are only using one pin of ESP32-C3 for driving all three LEDs. We did this because there are very few I/O pins available on the ESP32. All I/Os on this side are all unused because they are all actually supposed to be going to external flash for the ESP32. C3 designs. These chips support external flash memory for code storage, so we are not using that, and we are using the ESP32-C3FH4, which is having internal 4MB flash. So we are not allowed to use these pins because they are used for connecting external flash. So we are running short of IOs, and that's why we switched these RGB LEDs from IO driven LEDs to serial driven LEDs using the WS2812Bs. So this makes it very easy to manage these LEDs, and we are also driving these LEDs power using the power MOSFET of the cellular module. So whenever there is power to the cellular module, then only the LEDs are going to be powered. Otherwise, it doesn't make any sense to keep the LEDs on when the cellular is off. And this is the same nano SIM connector with push pull type configuration, so where you need to push it in and then use this hole to push it out. This design also supports external antenna, so we have routed the GNSS antenna pin of the SM670S to this UFL connector. You can connect an external active patch antenna or a big GPS antenna which you get with magnetic attachments and everything. But when you're ordering this, we will usually be shipping with the passive patch antenna configuration. If you want to use this part, then there is a resistor that needs to be connected for the bias and everything. So you need to let us know which one you want to use by default. Okay, so there will be only two variants, either with passive or with active. We have not tried enabling both of them together because there will be a necessary voltage going into the passive antenna when we enable the bias. So it's either this or that. So you can select the configuration beforehand when you finalize which one you want to use. Initially, you can order two separate designs for evaluation for passive configuration and the active antenna configuration. I've seen that the passive antenna gives you quite good results and it will get signal quite quickly compared to the earlier designs, and because the antenna size is big and there is a big ground plane provided below it. So the results are good, and you can I think you can get away with the passive antenna itself. The main advantage of switching to ESP32-C3 is that the development environment is available for free. We are using VSCODE with ESP-IDF framework, and it's quite easy to use, and there are a lot of examples available. So it took a very short time. I think only in 1 week we were able to port the full VALTRACK-V4-VTS-ESP-IDF, which are designed for STM32 to ESP32-C3, because this also uses free autos, and there was a very minimum changes that were done, and the libraries for I2C, IOAUT, everything was already there, and there are a lot of driver examples also on the ESP32, on the ESP-IDF. So we directly made use of it and started and got this up and running. Now we are able to transmit data using HTTP and MQTT using cellular. And we are able to get antenna range of about maybe 10-15 meters using this antenna. The intent of using this antenna is just for configuration purposes. We don't intend to use it for any other things. Let us start by connecting power to the board. I inserted the SIM card. Let me connect the LiPo battery for testing. So these are the RGB LEDs which I was talking about. It's a WS2812B LEDs. It's I think the part number is WS2812B2020. It's a smaller size, and I'm just running a Arduino code for Blinky example for testing these WS2812 LEDs. So let's actually connect to the main working board here. Now I have inserted the SIM card, and I'm connecting the 12 volt power source to it. As you can see, the first LED has turned on. It indicates that the 12 volt input is present. Now if I remove the 12 volt input, it will turn red, indicating that the main power has been removed, but it will still run out of the internal battery. Okay, after some initialization, you can see that the device has already acquired the network. The middle LED is for indicating that it has connected to the 4G network. And the last LED is for GPS signal. It will only come when we go outdoors. So that's all for now. This was the update regarding the new design using ESP32-C3. If you are interested in trying out this product, you can order from our website. It's available on valtrack.com/store. I will put the link in the description. You can order from there and we'll dispatch to you. So we do international shipping as well as domestic shipping as well. And if you have any questions regarding the device, you can mail me to ravi@valtrack.com and I will respond to you in 1 or 2 days time. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like, share and subscribe.